Jimmy, I'm just gonna say it. I gotta let you go.
You were just fired.
I was let go for liability reasons involving insurance.
The one-armed bartender.
You need to show a little respect.
Charlotte Motor Speedway. I know how they move the money.
The only guy who knows anything about blowing up real bank vaults is Joe Bang.
I am incarcerated.
Yeah, we got a plan to get you out.
Coca-Cola 600 is the biggest race of the year.
We need a computer whiz.
I know everything there is to know about computers, okay?
Me.
All the Twitters, I know them.
Welcome to the Coca-Cola 600.
Now, how many yards away is the vault?
20 yards. I don't know, maybe 30.
Is it 20 or is it 30? We are dealing with science here.
They're gonna know what we want them to know.
My life of crime is over.
That is massively stupid.
It's been handled.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
That looks like it hurt.
I want everything on Jimmy Logan.
I'm about to get naked. No bacon.
I said no bacon.
You Logans mustn't be as simple-minded as people say.
People say that.
Would you give me my arm, please?
Is it this one?
It's day 21 of movie month.
Yes, it's my fifth annual movie month, in which 30 days I watch 30 movies and do 30 podcasts like this one right here.
It's a very special day, everybody. Movie month 2018 is now old enough to drink. Today it turned 21, because today is day 21. 21 out of 30, 21 days in a row, 21 movies in a row, 21 podcasts in a row, and you've stuck with me through all of them. Thank you. Thank you. Hi, Dave. How's it going? I know you're out there. Today I watched a movie that I have to say I friggin' loved. Yes, today I saw Logan Lucky. Steven Soderbergh directed it. He didn't write it. He did direct it. He's the guy who directed all the Oceans movies, and I didn't know what this was going to be, but it was a heist movie, and I love heist movies. So the movie stars Channing Tatum and Adam Driver. They play these brothers from West Virginia, the Logans, who are supposed to be kind of bumbling fools. No one thinks they are very bright, and they have the big Southern drawls, but they're Southern people that aren't considered like rednecky. If that's a bad term, I don't know. But these are the guys that, like, one works in construction, the other one tends bar, and so that's Adam Driver, who tends bar, and his brother is Channing Tatum. Channing Tatum, who I saw earlier this month in Kingsman 2. Adam Driver, who I saw last year in Movie Month when I saw Midnight Special. But okay, that has nothing to do with this. So they are brothers who, Channing Tatum works in a construction company that is working to fill sinkholes in at the Charlotte Motor Speedway. And he gets fired. He lives in a trailer. He's got his daughter that he has with Katie Holmes, who has a new rich husband, who is a completely fine guy. Like, they didn't make this guy a jerk. He's from The Office. He played Pam's kind of jerky fiance before she went off with Jim. And he was totally, like, just a fine. He was fine, normal, friendly, no problem with him. So he's got to deal with, you know, his kid living in a nice house and he having nothing. So he decides to put together a heist with their old friend Joe Bang, who is Daniel Craig, in a who's in prison. So their whole thing is to break Daniel Craig out of prison, pull this heist off, and get Daniel Craig back into prison all on the same day without anyone noticing it. That's what the whole movie's about. And I don't want to give away anything more if you haven't seen it. So I just say, if you like heist movies, see this movie. It's very funny. It's like smart. It's quick. You know, there's twists and turns you don't see coming. And I love it when a plan comes together. Like, I remember, I actually pumped my fist and like, yes, this is it. You know, and there's a couple other guys I don't know, but they were very good in it. Just the whole movie overall. And, you know, all you see, you know, other actors show up. They're like, whoa, Hilary Swank is in this? I had no idea about that. And then the way the movie ends, I don't quite know, you know, do they get away with it? Do they don't? Did it happen? Was it successful? It's all kind of up in the air at the end of the movie. No, it's all up in the air through the whole movie, I should say. You know, the movie came out last year, so I'm going to start spoiling it. So if you haven't seen it yet, I'm going to spoil it at this point. Do they get away with it? It seems like everything up until the last moment of the movie, you think they get away with it. But then you see Hilary Swank moved into town and she's hanging out at the bar. So she either, she might want to get to the bottom of it. Hopefully she doesn't get to the bottom of it and those guys all live happily ever after, because the fact that Channing Tatum end up with the girl that he went to high school with I knew he would, the girl from the, that worked in the mobile hospital, and the fact that it looked like their sister was getting with Daniel Craig. So Channing Tatum got with the girl from the hospital. Daniel Craig might be with their sister. I'm like, oh, everyone's friends and everyone lives happily ever after and everyone's rich. Hopefully. Or rich, not rich, but they're well off. They got some of the money. I loved it when, you know, you think he gave back the money. I'm like, no, there has to be a twist. There has to be a twist where he gave back most of the money, but so enough that hopefully it'll, you know, the things will calm down and then they can show where the real money is. And it's just like all of a sudden the Fortunate Son started playing and you're like, oh, here it is. Here's the twist. And that's when I was like, yes, I love it. The movie was just so much fun. Overall, it was a quick 2 hours. It's produced partly through Amazon. I know it was in the theater, but it is on Amazon Prime now. And I'm assuming because it's an Amazon film, it'll be on Amazon Prime forever. I don't know how that works with Amazon. You know, with Netflix, if Netflix makes an original movie, it's only on Netflix and it'll be on Netflix pretty much forever. I don't see those things ever going away. But Amazon, I'm not sure how it works because it still had the ability to purchase it. I don't know. I'm not sure what else to say. I mean, 6 minutes is very short, but this movie was terrific. Very fun. Acting, you know, Channing Tatum, first time I saw him was not in Step Up. I never saw any of those Step Up movies, but I knew him from that. I saw him in a Amanda Bynes movie, She's the Man, where I think, they end up together at the end, I believe, where he's a soccer player. And she likes him, and they're friends, and then they end up together. Anyway, I don't know. I thought maybe he would just be that kind of guy. But he has broadened his acting ability. You know, he did the Magic Mike movies. I haven't seen those. He does the Jump Street movies. Those are great. A lot of fun. That's what actually made me start really liking him. Just he's been in other things. I didn't see the Foxfire. Is that the one? The one where he's the collegiate wrestler. I never saw that movie. But everything I like, and he was in Kingsman earlier this year. Everything I see him in now, I like him in. And if he's in a movie, it makes me go, oh, that's probably going to be good. Daniel Craig, who is friggin' James Bond. I mean, he's, you know, I'm not saying, oh, he's like James Bond. No, he is James Bond. He's been James Bond for the last, you know, whatever, 10 years. In this, he's playing a country guy. For a moment, it takes you out of it. And I'm like, oh, you know, can he pull off the country accent? That goes away after a while. Everything they did with the prisoner. So at the end, I love when they got the money and he gave chunks of money to all the people that helped them, whether they knew they were helping them or not. The woman who got the birthday cake, she got money back, who they hit her car. The guy in the prison, he got money. The blood bank, the mobile hospital got money. Like, Channing Tatum basically took care of everybody he could along the way. He was like Robin Hood, you know? And I loved that. I loved all these little, like when there was a limo waiting outside for the guy who got out of prison, who helped start the prison riot. Dwight Yoakam as the warden in the prison. The joke about the Song of Ice and Fire, the Game of Thrones books. The fact that they said, oh, we can get you Dance of Dragons, but we can't get these books out yet because they haven't been released yet. And the people are like, damn it. And the guy on the, you know, yelled out to the warden, George R. R. Martin said those books would be out 2 years ago. He's like, I don't want to tell you. I went on Wikipedia. They haven't been, he's been delayed. Damn it. And they're all angry. That was a great joke. I liked how every little thing they needed to do happened. They had a fight. They had, what I don't understand is Dwight Yoakam, I guess, beat up, Daniel Craig, threw him into solitary, I guess, until he got out. And then he got out of prison. So I don't know if that was, he was getting out anyway. I don't know what that was, or if he just kind of knew that something's up, so he just wanted to, put his authority, put his power on them. But that kind of ended after that. I liked it a lot. I love how they got back into the, they made it. Everything they needed to do to happen. It was it threw me off for a bit, and sometimes you hear his Family Guy characters come in, but Seth MacFarlane playing a British NASCAR driver, or NASCAR sponsor, I don't know what he is, that was kind of, funny. It was like out of left field that he was the guy, and then he had his NASCAR driver who was like, treated his body like a temple, but seemed to hate Seth MacFarlane. That was a weird little side story that didn't go very far, but it was just about character development. That was Sebastian Stan, who plays Bucky in all the Avenger movies, or some of the Avenger movies. So, yeah, I mean, I've rambled on and on and on. The fact that if you're still listening to this, God bless you. God bless you. This movie was terrific. I suggest you watch it, and I've spoiled everything for you, so I hope you've watched it. Watch it again, right? You disagree with me? You can tell me on Twitter at Geek Mentality. You can tell me on Instagram at Geek Mentality, on Facebook at Fans Not Experts. And the website is fansnotexperts.com. Search on Twitter, search on iTunes for Geek Mentality. And before I lose my voice, all my posts, all my pictures are at fansnotexperts.com. Every post is a place where you can leave comments. Their Facebook comments. I tried to put other comments in there, but they were coming in Spanish, and I don't speak Spanish, so I can't really, that's not very helpful to me. Okay? Oh my God, that moth is humongous. Anyway, thank you guys for listening. I have a feeling I might be going back to a series tomorrow. We'll see. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, until that moment, until that day, until tomorrow, tomorrow's only a couple hours away, and until then, I leave you with these four words. Here's the last two. Theme song.
This is my podcast. I made it. Geek Mentality is what I named it. And I think you should listen and subscribe. Cause I'm kind of funny and awesome. I think that I'm worth your time, and I'm kind of handsome. My mom says, please listen and please subscribe. At least listen to this episode.
Fans Not Experts.